our next fabrication process is a p-tab method, because we know that there are three method for a CMOS fabrication: n-tab method, p-tab method and twin-tab method. So CMOS, basically we are trying to implement both NMOS and PMOS on a single substrate. So these three methods are very, very important for implementation of our MOS. If you know the stick diagram and layout, we have a clear cut idea about the formation of any layer on that single substrate, and there are different methods are used for the implementation, just like your oxidation method, ion implantation method or diffusion method, metal sputtering method. These methods are used for, or is associated, these methods are associated with the fabrication of a MOS. So let us start with our p-tab method. Here silicon, pure silicon crystal is used for your p-tab method. This is your n-type material, so n-type material is used for our base material. Next we have a formation of our SiO2 layer, so we put this n-type material in a furnace at a high temperature, and we go for oxidation process. So thick oxide layer is formed on the surface of this substrate. Next we put a photoresist layer on, put a photoresist layer on that thin oxide layer for our pattern transformation. That means we go for photolithography technique. Then we make a window for our p-tab, so that window will be formed by using this photoresist layer, and some pattern will be transformed when we exposed this photoresist layer to some UV light. So that portion is transformed or removed from to for the formation of that window, and the rest will remain same. Then this window is formed. After formation of window, we just make a diffusion process, p diffusion on that window, and or it may be ion implantation method or ion bombardment method may be used for that p-tab formation. So this is shown in the figure. Next, another window is used for the formation of our gen material for our PMOS formation. So this is shown in the figure. The pattern will be transformed by removing our photoresist layer. So ultimately we get this p-tab with some n substrate and with some silicon dioxide surface. This is also shown in the figure. Then next step is to form our gate oxide by using a polysilicon material. So this polysilicon is used by chemical vapor deposition method. This is shown in the figure. This polysilicon material is used for our gate. So two portion are used here for that good gate material. One gate is for our PMOS, another gate for NMOS. Then again we transform some pattern for the formation of source, gate and drain. This is also shown in the figure, and by using a photolithography method, so these two gates are formed here, and this gate material are used for that means polysilicon's materials are used for that gate. Next we have a formation of that gate. This is shown in the figure, and on a thin oxide layer we have a gate material, polysilicon. Then again by using photolithography technique, again we transform some pattern from pattern to form the source, gate and drain. This is shown in the figure for the subsequent figure, and ultimately we got a P plus region or P region on that N substrate and N plus region on that N substrate, P tab. So and P plus region, and obviously P regions which will represent your PMOS and N represent your NMOS. Here the entire circuit circuit diagram or entire MOS fabrication is shown in the figure. Last the here next pattern is transformed for our metallization process. For the metallization process, basically we are using a sputtering method. By using the sputtering method, we can implement our metal contact. So the metal contact is shown in the figure. Here P region we represent source drain, N region also represent source drain, and ultimately we got a two MOS. One is called your P channel MOS on that N substrate, and another is called your N MOS in the P tab, and in between you have for your P substrate some N region is connected to is taken as your substrate. For your P tab this N plus P plus region is taken, P region is taken for that substrate. Then ultimately we got some inverter circuit where a source is connected to VDD in the P region, then two gate region are short circuited to make a input voltage, and from that so drain that is from one drain and another drain of our PMOS are connected to get the output voltage, and this source represent your grounded for your N channel MOS. This is shown in the figure. So we can implement our CMOS on a single wafer by using a P-tab method. So that's all for today's class.